Hello, my name is Ravi Vich. I'm from My Cancer Haven. And today I have with me Dr. Jay Yang, Associate Professor in the Department of Oncology at Wayne State University School of Medicine in Detroit, Michigan. And as part of our Conversation with Cancer Experts series, we're going to be talking about how I approach frontline treatment of unfit AML patients. So Jay, welcome. I'm glad to have you here.
Good afternoon. Thanks for inviting me.
So Jay, obviously, we are going to today talk about the treatment of unfit patients. But before we go there, how do you define the unfit patient?
Yeah, that's a good question. Whenever we see someone with AML, you know, we do try to do a pretty comprehensive evaluation of the patient. And we take into account a lot of factors. You know, age, of course, is important, but in some sense, it's just a number. We do take into account their medical problems, you know, diabetes, lung conditions, kidney conditions, those type of things. We take into account what we call their performance status. And that's kind of an idea of how well they function day to day in their daily life. And then, you know, there are some formal metrics that we can use, scales that you fill out forms and you plug in numbers to come up with a number. But usually we sort of globally evaluate the patient in the clinic as we see them. We take into account their lab values as well, kidney function, liver function, heart function. And all of those things combined, we sort of evaluate the patient and see whether they're considered, in this instance, fit or frail. And this illustration is a good one. And of course, most patients, while we do try to